Hello, welcome to the Combs Kitchen. We're getting ready to make supper, and it's kind of like an odd concoction that I came up with. It's going to be wide noodles with linguine sauce, with meatballs and broccoli. So it's going to be meatball, broccoli, linguine. I don't know what I'm going to call it, but that's pretty much the gist of it. Now, on the description of my channel, I say that I give advice. So, this is something that you might want to make for your partner on Valentine's Day coming up. I think that Italian is a romantic dish to serve. And I'm tired of all the tomato-based Italian that I've had recently. That's why tonight I went with the linguine sauce. So I think it's going to be good. Now, Michelle and I, we're just alike. And I love her. She loves me. But we're both very opinion-oriented. And we're both take-charge kind of people. And so that kind of happened with tonight's dinner, because I wanted the wide noodles, she wanted the linguine noodles. So it was, we had some back and forth because both of us, we have our own opinions. And I'll tell you, it's hard for me because I have FOBO, fear of better options. And I go through like 3 or 4 or 6 different things that I might want to eat before I come up with a decision. And once I make a decision, it's hard for me to, take any other suggestions, because I've pretty much made up my mind. And Michelle, she's pretty much the same way. But anyway, we're going to have an amazing dinner. I hope that advice was helpful. And I'm going to show you the pans. Already got my pans on the stove. I kind of messed up because I was going to have my pan preheated. And I forgot to turn it on. But it's okay. I'm going to go ahead and preheat the oven too, because I'm going to have some garlic bread here in a minute. So I'm going to go ahead and start my meatballs, because they're frozen. They might take a minute. I'll tell you, that rubber band caught my that rubber band, it hurt my fingers. You know how when you flip somebody, it came back and flipped me. Let's see. You know what? Michelle, she is really helpful. She brought these scissors over here to help me out. All right.
The lid is on top of the toaster.
Here's my lid. All right. Hello. I was wanting to finish up on my story because I knew there was something else that we were disagreeing on about this dinner. And it's not a big deal, but she wanted to use the frozen chicken patties that we have in the freezer instead of the Swedish meatballs. And to me, the frozen chicken patties are for sandwiches, you know, and I wanted to get rid of the meatballs, so we just sort of went with it because I just came over here and started making it. So, but it's going to be okay. We're going to have a good meal, and you know, sometimes you just got to make a decision. So, you know, when you can't decide like where to eat, sometimes you just got to whip into a parking lot and go with wherever you want to eat at. And then once everybody starts eating, everybody's happy anyway. So, we're having a good time. Michelle, she's over there. She's helping me. She's brought me my scissors and given me advice. And boy, I love having her with me when I do any project. She makes it all go so much simpler. Well, I'll catch you in a minute. Now, I'm going to tell you another thing that we disagreed on. We disagreed on the garlic bread because I wanted homemade garlic bread and she wanted to use Walmart Texas toast. So, I decided that since I was making it, I was going to do it all my way. So, you know, sometimes you just got to do that in a relationship. When you're in a disagreement, you're going to say, well, we're going to do what we're going to do. But everything's good because Michelle, she is on board with it. You know, that's a test of a relationship is how well you can handle disagreements. You know it? And Michelle, she said she wanted at least 3 pieces of this garlic toast. So I'm gonna make 6 slices because I'll probably eat that many myself. And let me tell you a little secret. Michelle knows a lot of helpful stuff. And let me tell you the thing that she's helped me out with the most. I used to love to make grilled cheese sandwiches, and I'd butter my bread just like that and put it in the pan and fry it. And she said, you know what, if you put mayonnaise on it instead of butter, it'll turn out twice as good. And I told her, I said, that is the craziest thing I've ever heard in my life. And you know what? I did it, and well, I might have even watched her do it. And you know what? That was the best tasting grilled cheese sandwich I had ever ate. And I do it that way every single time I make a grilled cheese sandwich. And I'll tell you, if you've never used mayonnaise instead of butter fry your grilled cheese sandwich in the pan, you need to try it because it is totally awesome.
Make sure it's a very thin layer of mayonnaise.
I'm just going to use a little bit of this garlic salt. And There we go. Now my bread's ready to go in the oven, but I'm going to wait till it's almost done to put it in, but it's already prepped and ready to go. That was so easy. I'm going to give this a stir, and I'm going to use this plastic ladle instead of a spatula, because I don't want to break nothing up. And I'm glad I put this in here when Michelle told me to, because it's taking longer than I thought it would. So, you know, she is really helping me out, even when I take charge, she still makes sure that what I do turns out good. That makes for a really good partnership. I am going to go ahead and add my Del Monte mushrooms, because I always feel like I wait too long to put my mushrooms in, and I always feel like I don't get them hot enough. So I'm going to put them in extra early this time. That way they'll be nice and hot. Because I like everything super hot, you know what I mean? I'm just going to let them, the steam heat them up, so I'm not going to stir them in until they've been in there a few minutes. That water is starting to boil. I can see it boiling in the bottom, and it only takes them noodles 6 minutes to cook. So I need to make sure that this over here is mostly done before the noodles go in, because it won't hurt this over here to simmer for 6 minutes even after it's done. What I'm going to do is I'm going to get me a fork, and I'm going to cut up some of them pieces of broccoli, because I don't like really huge pieces of broccoli. Let's see here. You know what? I'm not going to do that, because I just realized that if I scratch Michelle's pan up, she is going to be very upset, and I don't blame her, because I would be upset. So I'm just gonna not worry about the big pieces of broccoli.
Oh no, that makes it good. You can probably add your sauce, it'll help everything defrost a little faster.
Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and add my sauce, because I'm in agreement with Michelle, because this over here needs to be completely done. Now, I'm going to get Michelle to pour me about a half a cup of milk in this thing, so I can get
the rest of the sauce
out.
You want to know?
Well, I haven't poured this in there yet. I'm still shaking it. I don't want it to be too runny.
Too sloppy.
We can always add more, but I can't take it out unless I just really boil it to death. I'll tell you, that looks like that's going to be pretty good sauce. I think I'm going to like them meatballs and the broccoli. Nicholas is going to spend the night at a friend's house.
Cousin's house.
Well, friend, cousin. Your cousins are your first friends, you know. And we were going to wait until he left to start making supper. And we said, we can't wait that long. We are hungry. That's the hardest part about making these videos, is when you make them, most of the time you are starved to death. Thought I'd give you a better look at our sauce. Doesn't that look like that's going to be good? I think so. So, we'll catch you in a few minutes.
Everybody, I just came over here to check on dinner because I'm letting Steven pretty much do this by himself tonight, and I've had to do some course corrections, but so far he's doing a really good job on his own.
Boy, I think she is absolutely amazing. I love Michelle. Well, I stirred that and she just got through doing it. Oh well. My water is at a rolling boil, so I'm going to go ahead and add the noodles. And I'm going to set my timer for 6 minutes. And I'm going to go ahead and stick my bread in the oven, because we want it to get done around the same time as everything else. So I'm going to give this a stir. And we'll see where we're at in 6 minutes. All right, Michelle, she's going to season it for me.
She's going to add a little bit of black pepper to give it a little bit of a kick.
I used to ask someone that I cared very deeply about what the secret ingredient that I always use in my food was. And do you remember the answer, Michelle?
There is no secret.
Well, I used to always say that the secret ingredient was love.
There is no secret.
So that's my secret ingredient, is I put love in my food, or I try to.
I love my food.
Yeah, well, I do too. I love eating it. Michelle just put the bread on broil.
Yes, it's going to toast the top of the bread where the bottom is already toasted. Door's being left open so I can see it so it doesn't burn.
Now what I was going to do, Michelle, is I was going to strain them noodles and pour that sauce right in that other bowl.
In the pot with the noodles?
In the pot with the noodles and stir it up.
That's fine.
All right. All right, my timer went off, so my noodles are ready to be strained. So none of them stuck to the bottom of my pot. I'm going to dump them right back in here.
And here is the bread.
I don't know if I paused the video or not. I don't. Let's see. Oh, yeah, it's still going. Well, there's the bread. I'm going to bring you over here to let's get a closer inspection of this.
Almost like a stroganoff. Because of the egg noodles?
Yeah. Well, see, I like little bite-sized pieces of noodles, you know?
All right. I've got it pretty much mixed in. Did you want me to put Parmesan in it, or do you just want to put it on it?
I'll just put it on it at the table.
All right.
All right. All right. I'm going to dish this up here. Thank you, honey. Let's see. I didn't hardly give her any meatballs. Let me try to get her a few meatballs. There we go. And I'll tell you, she likes the broccoli too. She's a big fan of broccoli, so I'm gonna make sure I get her a nice big piece. My friend at work has been trying to get me to eat healthier, so that's why I'm eating broccoli tonight. All right.
Did you want the Parmesan?
Yeah, I'm gonna go get us the Parmesan.
Probably on the shelf, honey.
Well, I got some, but I didn't know if we had some already open.
We finished it the other day.
Oh, we already finished it?
Yep.
All right. Well, I'm going to leave that with you. I remembered I had this Kobe Jack cheese. I'm going to use that on mine.
Okay.
There we go. Do you want some of this? All right.
I have never had meatballs with Alfredo, so this is different.
Well, this is just something I came up with because I needed to get rid of the meatballs because we used them in a different dish last night.
Pretty good.
Yep, my meatballs hot all the way through, so that was a concern that they might be a little cool in the middle, but they're hot all the way through, so I did a good job at least on that one.
I ate a good sized piece of broccoli and it was hot all the way through.
So let me ask you, Michelle.
What?
If you were dating a man and he made this for you for Valentine's Day, would you be pleased or would you be disappointed?
I'd be happy he cooked for me to begin with and that it was edible. So I'd be pleased as punch to eat this.
You know what? I'm going to go get the salt because I think
it needs just a little bit.
Now, Nicholas hasn't left yet, but he doesn't need to eat with us because he's going to eat
with his cousins.
With his cousins at their house tonight. So he doesn't need to eat twice. So he's in there
playing video games.
You know, I am really liking that broccoli. I'm so glad I decided to eat healthy tonight.
I'm glad we went with only one jar. It dropped some of the calories. It could have been in this.
Yeah. Well, I don't think I skimped at all because I think it's really good. The way it is.
I agree.
And I agreed with you when you said we shouldn't waste two cans on just two people. So it worked out good all the way around.
Yes, it did.
Well, I hope you enjoyed tonight's video. I hope you learned something. I hope that your relationship with whoever you're with is just as awesome as mine and Michelle's, if not better. And we'll catch you next time.
Bye.
Bye.